من كبار هيئة العلماء. So we reach the point where it was in regard to الكفر بالاعتقاد. الكفر بالاعتقاد. Disbelief that is due to any form of belief that the person has that is from the opposite of the religion of Islam. For instance, وهو أن يعتقد الإنسان بقلبه ما يناقض الإسلام. I said the person he holds a belief of that which will nullify the religion. For instance, كأن يعتقد أن الصلاة غير واجبة. Like a person he believed that the salah is not an obligation. Believing that the salah is not an obligation. That belief is a disbelief itself. وليس لها قيمة. And it doesn't hold no value. That the salah is just a matter of action that a person does. It's not important. And as the munafiqeen, they used to do it, not seeing no importance to the salah. So, فَيَأْتِي بِالْأَعْمَالِ الظَّاهِرَةِ. The person will bring about the outwardly actions. وَلَكِنْ مِنْ قَلْبِهِ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِهَا. But if it is pertaining to his heart, he doesn't believe in anything. If it is pertaining to his heart, he doesn't believe in anything. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he described to us the statement of the hypocrites. When he mentioned in Surah Al-Munafiqun, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ قَالُوا نَشْهَدُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ. When the hypocrites, they will come to you and they will bear witness that you are indeed the messenger of Allah. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُهُ. That Allah knows that you are indeed his messenger. وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَاذِبُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bear witness that the hypocrites, they are the liars. اتخذوا أيمانهم جنة. That they are taking their oath as a shield. They are taking their oath as a shield. So meaning that they are protecting themselves. Walaikum salam. That they are taking a shield and they are protecting themselves with it. Or they are covering themselves by way of actions or the actions that they do. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say why that the hypocrites, they are liars. Because يَقُولُونَ بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ مَا لَيْسَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. That they speak that which with their tongue in that regard to that is not yani in their hearts. They speak with their tongues that which is not in their hearts. يَقُولُونَ بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. They will speak with their tongue. مَا لَيْسَ. That which is not في قلوبهم in their hearts. So therefore, believing in the heart, believing in the heart of a matter of kufr, صار كافرا. That the person will be a disbeliever. Now, ولو لم يفعل أو يتكلم, it doesn't matter whether or not he put forth the actions or not. The minute he believe in his heart, then بارك الله فيكم, that is a disbelief. He say, وَلَوْ كَانَ بِظَاهِرِهِ يَفْعَلَ الْأَعْمَالَ الطَّيِّبَ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ وَالْجِهَادِ وَالصَّدَقَةِ وَأَنْ يَقُولُ كَلِمَ الطَّيِّبِ بِأَنْ يَقُولُ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنْ بِقَلْبِهِ يَكْذِبُ بِذَلِكَ فَهَذَا كَافِرٌ وَهَذَا كَافِرٌ وَهَذَا دِينٌ وَهَذَا دِينُ الْمُنَافِقِ الَّذِينَ هُمْ في درك الأسفل من النار ولن تجد لهم نصيرا مع كونهم يصلون ويصومون ويجاهدون ولكن لما كانوا بقلوبهم كافرين صاروا في درك الأسفل من النار لأنهم لا يعتقدون بقلوبهم ما تنطق به ألسنتهم أو ما تفعله جوارحهم من الأعمال المشروعة. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he mentioned, if a person believes in his heart about a disbelief matter, then that automatically will make him a disbeliever. Even if he, وَلَوْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ, even if he doesn't put forth the action, أَوْ يَتَكَلَّمْ, or he doesn't say nothing. The minute that he has it in his heart, then this is disbelief. He say, وَلَوْ كَانَ even if بِظَاهِرِهِ outwardly يَفْعَلُ الْأَعْمَالَ الطَّيِّبَةِ he will put forth the righteous actions. He will put forth the righteous actions. The likes of the salah, min as-salah. Where is your notebook? Where is your notebook? Where is your notebook? When you come in next time, bring your notebook, okay? You come in for the class to benefit, to take something home. You gotta have a notebook. So you write something, at least if it is a sentence, you can write when you go home, you can educate somebody with it, rather than just wondering, right? So write because I would ask you. So he mentioned, وَلَوْ كَانَ بِظَاهِرِهِ even if the person outwardly يَفْعَلْ الْأَعْمَالُ الطَّيِّبَةِ he will do the good actions. مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ from the likes of الصَّلَاةِ والجهاد and striving the cause of Allah وَالصَّدَقَ and giving صَدَقَ and the likes. طيب وَيَقُولُ كَلَامُ الطَّيِّبِ and he do say the statement of good. For instance, بِأَنْ يَقُولُ he say أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ let's say he say he bear witness that there is none worthy of worship but Allah وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ and he bear witness that indeed Muhammad is a messenger of Allah وَلَكِنْ but this individual that do all of these things all of these good things that he do وَلَكِنَّهُ بِقَلْبِهِ but in his heart he is denying it he is belying it in his heart by way of these so therefore he say because of this بِذَلِكَ فَهَذَا كَافِرٌ this is disbelief this is a disbeliever وَهَذَا دِينُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ and this is the religion of this is the religious way of the hypocrites because the hypocrites they will say words they will do actions but they will not believe in what they say or do so this is the deen of the hypocrites الَّذِينَ هُمْ those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in regard to the final abode يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي دَرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ they will be from the bottom pit of the hellfire وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُمْ نَصِيرًا they will not find no help in it. Now, this is the deen of the hypocrite. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the hypocrites. فِي دَرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ they will be from the bottom pit of the hellfire and they will not find no help or no rescue or no protection in there. He say, مَعَ كَوْنِهِمْ and bear in mind that the hypocrites, they used to pray. أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ they used to pray. أَنُ يُصَلُّونَ وَيَصُومُونَ they used to fast. They used to fast, they used to pray, بَارَكَ فِيكُمْ and they used to even fight in the cause of Allah. They used to fight in the cause of Allah. وَلَكِنْ but the reality, لَمَّا كَانُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ when it resided in their hearts, the disbelief, that they became disbeliever. They became disbeliever. So saru, and this is why the hypocrites in Yawm al-Qiyamati, fi dark asfali min al-nar, they will be from the bottom pit of the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. Why? لِأَنْهُمْ لَا يَعْتَقِدُونَ بِقُلُوبِهِمْ because they did not believe of what their tongue was saying. They did not believe of what their tongue was saying. أَوْ مَا تَفْعَلُ جَوَارِحِهِمْ and they did not believe of whatever their actions was doing. When they say, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ they didn't believe it. When they were praying, they didn't believe it. When they giving charity, they didn't believe it. طيب. And from all those actions that are, from the actions that are, بَارَكَ فِيكُمْ established and legislated by Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this was barakallahu fikum the second asl in regard to the usul of those usul of what of ridda alaykum assalam. So we have mentioned the first one was what, Aba Asma? What was the first one? Naam. Ahsanta, a statement a person will say. A statement a person will say. Adam, you remember the example? A statement a person will say, and that will lead him to, barakallah, disbelief. Now that statement, whether he was joking or he was serious, that statement, barakallah fikum, will what? Will count. Is there exception? Hal fihi, is there an exception in it? Omar? Bayin. Ahsanta, unless the person is forced. Now, when the person is forced, there is two conditions, Adam. Number one? Believe it in the heart. Number two, Muhammad, the second condition. To relieve yourself, to free yourself from the torture of the disbelievers. So these are the two conditions of the one that is al-mukrih, the one that is being compelled, the one that is being forced. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, illa man ukriha wa ash wa qalbuhu mutma'innun bil iman. So the second was al-i'tiqad, the belief. So the person believing in something that is disbelief, then he is a disbeliever. It doesn't matter whether he does the action or not. It doesn't matter whether he say the statement or not. Because the munafiqeen, طيب, they Allah described them that their final abode yawm al-qiyamati will be what? Fi dark al-asfali min al-nar. But ma'a annahum kanu yusalluna ma'a an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That they used to pray with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to fast with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to fight in the cause of Allah with the Messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam. وَذَلِكَ لَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ. They did not benefit them. لماذا؟ لأنهم اعتقلوا في قلوبهم الكفر. Because they had disbelief in their heart. They had indeed disbelieved in their heart. So والكفر بالفعل. Now we're coming into the action. Or the person will do it that can lead him to apostate al-Islam. So, yep, a person do an action that could lead him to kufr. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, Shafadhan, he say, كَأَنْ يَذْبَحْ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ. Like the person he slaughter for other than for Allah. Like say, the person he slaughter for other than for Allah. Because we have indeed mentioned the anwa'u al-dhabiha, or the anwa'u al-dhabh, right? The types of dhabh, right? Ustaz? Right, a person he slaughtered animal because he want to eat. The person he slaughtered for the sake of Allah. Udhiya, na'am. He has a guest. Right, he has a guest he want to slaughter. Right? I'm not going to give no example. Right? He got a guest and he want to slaughter. Na'am, Adam. No, we're talking about the yes, Abdul Jalil. Right, when Allah bless you with something that you've been looking for, so you slaughter. Barakallah fikum, shukran lillah. Being grateful to Allah the Most High. Na'am. Right, the udhiyah, yes, the udhiyah. What else, Ismail? Yes, to sell, you know, slaughter because the person needs some money and he want to slaughter to sell, yes. Yes, the person has a walima. As the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam say to Abu Zar, awlim walaw bishat. Do the walima even if you're going to slaughter a goat. The likes of this. And these are the permissible ways of slaughter. Na'am. And also the person have a baby he slaughter. These are the slaughter that are permissible. And we had covered this many times. Yes. Huh? What do you mean? To eat and drink? Yeah. He mentioned it. I think who said it? Those drummers said it. To, you know, to slaughter because you want to eat and drink. You know, I mean, you want to drink. You want to eat. Meaning.
What about the deceased one?
Somebody sick?
Yeah.
You want to slaughter for them?
Yeah.
Right? That's permissible. That's permissible. Huh? No, he said somebody sick. Somebody sick.
Somebody sick.
That you want to slaughter